Some people think I'm a little weird just because I take the words of songs and change them to be about my dog. Like, I don't sing Sade's, "He's a smooth operator." I sing, "He's a smooth coat, Jack Russell." And it's not Beyonce, "To the left, to the left. Everything you own in the box, to the left." No, it's, "To the left, to the left. All your doggy treats in the box, to the left." And just because my dog has a polo outfit for every season, a pimped out Brewer's hat, and a Gucci spring jacket doesn't mean my dog is spoiled. He was dressed like Super Grover on Halloween, wore a tuxedo for New Year's, and on Christmas I took pictures of him on Santa's lap and gave them as presents. But before you judge me, please understand, he is 12 pounds of pure joy, a spontaneous love missile that launches in my arms, exploding in saliva dreams. He twirls his blessings in front of me, a carousel packed with smiles. But the best part, he fits perfectly into my lap, like the child I never had. And I find myself feeling awkward at supposed to be happy moments, like baby showers and weddings, when intrusive family members ask me the same question. "So when are you having a baby?" I freeze in mid-conversation. I run to clothesline my tear ducts, swallow sad stories. I don't want to rehash the pain of waking up in a maternity ward 6 months too soon, 15 staples across my belly. No more baby. I could give some kind of cliche answer of how poetry is the only life I need to feel outside of my body. But honestly, I'm starting to feel like a cracked porcelain doll missing all of her accessories. But see, my dog, he looks at me like I'm perfect. Like, maybe it's not a mistake. This is just the way it's supposed to be. I have more time for my friends, my family, and my mentee. So no, you won't find any cute, chubby finger paintings on my refrigerator door. You will find a framed picture of my dog that says, "My dog is cuter than your dog," which of course matches his t-shirt that says, "My owner is cuter than your owner." And you won't hear me singing any ABCs to my future prodigy. You will hear me singing off key to my newest favorite remake, also from Beyonce. "If you liked it, then you should've put a leash on it. If you liked it, then you should've put a leash on it. Just put your paws up." Or you might hear me rapping to one of my old school classics like, "No doggy can run quite like he can. He'll take a muscle bomb boxer, leave his face in the sand. He's not a pit bull, a Jack that won't stop. He'll have you saying, 'Hey Jackson, let's take a walk.' If you think you could outrun him, oh boy, I bet. But I ain't even see a greyhound that could do that yet. A face licker, though his breath ain't good, he's got a gold doggy tag that says, 'I wish you would.'" See, the cornier, the better. The more I laugh, he smiles his little doggy smile, and all the while, he's teaching me to live in the moment, because to him, everything is wonderful. So no more chewing on broken glass shame. He taught me, put my face in the wind, let my tongue hang, let the pain roll off like drool, y'all, cause through it all, he has been my sidekick, riding shotgun. He is my bestie and my home skillet. And though I caught a lot of criticism because I had to spend $2,000 to save his little doggy life, but to me, it was worth it. See, if dog is man's best friend, my little Jackson, he's my family.